dear students. You like it? Actually, this is not at all one shawl. I bought three colored shawls and joined like this. Is this beautiful? Then, this design. You can see this design stitched throughout the border. Is it? This is in rectangular shape. Is it? Yes, rectangular shape. You can see here throughout the border. Throughout the border, that is throughout the sides, I stitched this design. Can you say the one word for throughout the border? Very good. It's perimeter, is it? In mathematics, we covered the border. That means perimeter of rectangle, is it? So, dear students, just look around us. All our actions based upon mathematics. You can find out the concept of area and perimeter throughout our actions. So, today we are going to find out the application of perimeter and area in our daily life. So, dear students, wishing you a very happy morning and a warm welcome to the application day of mathematics. Are you ready? From our daily life, we can relate the all actions to perimeter or to area. For example, using lip balm. Okay, using lip balm. We take the lip balm and spread throughout our yes, lip. Is it students? Throughout our lip. That means yes, area of our lip. Is it? So we are covering throughout the lip means area of our lip. Using powder, it's related to area. Stitching our dress is related to perimeter, is it? Then washing our face, we can relate to area, because when we wash, we cover all our face, is it? The space on our face, is it? We can relate all actions to the concepts area and perimeter. In your textbook, exercise 11.4 consists of number of examples, number of exercise works related to the application of area and perimeter in our daily life. Practical life. So, we can go through one exercise work. So, the question is, a veranda of width 2.25 meter is constructed all along outside a room which is 5.5 meter long and 4 meter wide. Okay. So, you have given already a rectangular shape. Which is in a rectangular shape? Yes, the room. Already given, a room is in a rectangular shape. Got it? And its length is 5.5, width is 4 meter. So, we have already a room of given length and breadth. Got it? Then, all along outside the room, we are going to construct a veranda of width 2.25 meter. Got it? That is, the given concept is, already you have a room of length and width. That is, length of 5.5. Width of 4, okay, it's the room, and all side, throughout all side we are constructing a veranda of width 2.25, throughout all side, so throughout this side we are going to construct a veranda, like this, got it students, throughout means, yes, you know, this length is 2.5, this is 2.5, this is 2.5. Got it, students? So, this is the condition. Simply, you can find out the area of veranda. You know, after constructing veranda, we get a large rectangle. Is it, students? We already have our room, the small rectangle. After constructing the veranda, we get a large rectangle. So, simply, by subtracting the area of small rectangle from large, is it? Small rectangle from large, we get the area of this portion. Is it students? Area of this portion. Is it right? So simply we can find out the area. Next one, cost of cementing the floor of the veranda at the rate of ₹200 per meter. So when we find the area, we get the measurement in meter square, is it? Because the units here given are in meter. Then for 1 meter square, 200 rupees. So cementing the floor,
The action
cementing the floor is related to the concept area. Is it, students? In the same way, we can say that tiling. Is it tiling the floor? It's also related to area. Cleaning the floor. It's also related to area. Is it, students? Polishing the floor. It's also related to area. Then pointing the tiles. Pointing the tiles. It's an example of perimeter. Is it? Because the pointing means it related to border of tiles. So it's an example for perimeter. The actions around us we can categorize into two columns. Related to area, related to perimeter. So this is your today's activity. You can start from your bed. Covering the bed sheet. It's an example for area. Is it, students? So from that you can start. Just think your all actions. Simply you can understand which are related to area, which are related to perimeter. So just find out 10 actions for area, 10 actions for perimeter. So I hope tomorrow at the DCS time I will get an interesting output. Is it? Find out the actions and categorize in a good manner. Thank you.